April 3rd, 1974, dawned like any ordinary day. Americans across the Midwest bought their morning paper to catch up on the Patty Hearst kidnapping and President Nixon's tax troubles. While forecasters were predicting scattered thunderstorms, the unseen atmospheric forces above the heart of America were inching perilously towards volatility. At 11 a.m., the heavens opened up. Baseball-sized hail broke windows and tree limbs in central Illinois. At 12:10 p.m., the first tornado of the day touched down, damaging some billboards in Morris, Illinois. By 2 o'clock, a tornado struck Decatur, killing an elderly man in his mobile home while seriously injuring his wife.
As the day unfolded and we were running back and forth to the teletype that was spinning out the reports and the warnings.
Storm warning has been changed to a tornado warning for Metro Louisville, Jefferson County.
We're seeing that, though, there's just storms everywhere. It's even bigger area than we expected it to be. We're getting Fujita excited at that point. He's pumped.
Sirens blared in the few towns equipped with warning systems. Even then, residents barely had time to take cover.
You literally had people all over the country driving their cars off to the side of the road and jumping in ditches to try to get out of the paths of these tornadoes.
People watched in horror as more tornado funnels formed. Until darkness fell, when they could no longer see the devils approaching.
There were people who, lacking a basement, took shelter in the bathrooms of their houses and were found dead in bathtubs. There were people who did what you were supposed to do and rushed to their basement, who were found dead in the rubble of their basement.
While the tornadoes continued to rage into the next morning, Fujita scrambled to assemble Cessna crews so he could survey the damage before it was too late.